So here we are now, finally, with Ben Folds 5. Before we talk, guys, I thought, you still planning to open with the song you were going to open with?
Yeah.
Okay, because what I said earlier was, when I played the recorded version of Best Imitation of Myself, I said that we would then have the band live on the radio imitating the imitation of themselves. And we'll see which one we like better. Okay, so here we go, live on the radio. On 102.7, it's Ben Folds 5.
I feel like a quote out of context, withholding the rest, so I can be free what you want to see.
Well, you know, it really is uncanny. It really did. It really did sound just like you guys. Actually, it was pretty cool. That was all right. Robert Sledge, is that correct?
Yes, it is.
On bass guitar.
Howdy, Van, and howdy, New York listeners.
Now I detect a slight Southern accent there.
Where you guys are
from the South, right? You're from one of the Carolinas, right?
Right. We're from the Northern Carolina, Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
Chapel Hill, a hotbed of all kinds of cool stuff, all kinds of cool music.
Superchunk, Artists of Love, Scorn and Zippers.
Southern Culture on the Skids.
Southern Culture on the Skids. Lots of bands.
Paulvo.
It doesn't. Stamey lives down there now, I think.
Yes.
Chris Stamey, doesn't he? Yeah, and he's
Stamey.
He's involved in a whole bunch of productions down there as well. I've never been there. Never hung out
well,
there.
Well, you should come.
Yeah, you think so, Ben?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Ben Folds on the keyboard. And our drummer, who was flailing away like Animal from the Muppets, Darren Jesse. I knew you would appreciate that. I knew you'd be into that.
Well.
That's cool. I have to ask the stupid basic question.
Why the name Five?
Yes.
What gives?
Right.
Ben?
Because there's only three of you. It's the Ben.
Yeah.
One would look at the group and think Ben Folds 3, yeah. Ben Folds Trio. Ben Folds 5 has that kind of jazzy sort of sound to it and everything, but there are no five guys. So
we were sitting around and we were doing building a model of USS Enterprise. And, we kind of gave up on the model part and we started sniffing glue. The airplane glue.
This will then distort certain thought processes, right?
We really thought there was five people in the band.
I busted a synapse.
By the time we figured it out, it's too late.
Yeah.
And it stuck because our fame happened so quickly.
Unfortunately, Robert still does think there's five people in the band.
Well, Robert's never quite come down from the glue, then. Is that that's the case, huh?
That's true.
Why do people keep calling me the glue?
Well, see?
On the bass, we have the glue.
Now, who's got the model? That's what I want to know. Where is the Enterprise?
I don't think it never got finished.
It never got finished. It's just got, that little arm thing on the side is hanging off.
This is the Starship Enterprise.
Yeah.
Star Trek thing, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I have a feeling that's not the real answer, but I'll accept that. That could be the radio. That could be the radio.
You can't slip anything past Ben.
Somebody said something about your five fingers. You're a piano player, right?
Mm-hmm.
And is that getting closer or not?
That works. I think it was just a really bad math joke.
Okay.
Really is what it was.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any significance, and we couldn't. I figured out one thing, though, that we could say, which is it's five people on the firing squad, and three of them have the real bullets, and two of them have blanks. No one knows who killed the person.
I don't think that's true. I think there's usually like nine people on a firing squad, and only one of them, only one has the bullet.
You doubt me?
Yeah.
Then you are wrong.
Well, in that case, let's go to another song. Okay, what are you going to do next for us, Ben?
It's called "Where's Summer Be." Okay. It's about my roommate, which is Darren's girlfriend, and his acquaintance of Robert's.
I know her.
I've been telling people all week long that we got a baby grand piano up to the station for Ben Folds 5, and everybody who wasn't necessarily familiar with Ben Folds 5 said, oh, it's going to be a kind of a quiet, kind of a laid-back sort of an appearance. And I said, no, this will be one of the loudest visits that we'll ever have on Sunday night. It's amazing. Three guys, relatively
small.
Yeah, but man, a lot of volume coming out of you guys. Conscious decision on your part early on, Ben and the rest of the band, to make this thing be real loud when it looks like it would be a more laid back kind of a situation?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that makes it fun. And the bass and the drums, are playing as if they're playing behind a pretty loud guitar player.
Yeah,
I play through a Marshall, stack like a guitar player does.
So the piano is actually rigged through an amplifier as well, right?
Yeah.
Which is unusual. I mean, most people usually just mic a piano, don't they?
Yeah, well, most people just use a digital piano, actually, these days.
Yeah.
But if they, if they use a real piano, a lot of times they even MIDI them. That's a computer thingy where they use a computer sample of a piano, and they play the real piano, but what you hear out front is a recording.
Really?
That's true. That's what Billy Joel and Elton John and the cats, they do that.
I mean, they're playing live, but you're not actually hearing those notes.
You're hearing the notes. Each note is triggering off
a digital
reproduction of each particular note. So it's like actually what you're hearing is a digital piano out front. The piano that their real pianos trigger the sound of the other instrument.
What's the reason for that? Why?
Well, because they're more efficient for the sound men, and it sounds cleaner, faster. I mean, what we've got rigged up, drums and bass and everything go into the piano and make the sound imperfect.
Uh-huh.
That's the worst thing that could possibly happen, huh? It'd be imperfect.
But that's part of the pleasure of listening to your record, is that imperfection, is that distortion from time to time, is that bass-heavy sound, that kind of almost sounds like it's being played through a broken amplifier or something,
Yeah, it was.
It's calculatedly charming.
Yeah, calculatedly charming. You mentioned one of the key figures in pop music who uses a keyboard and writes songs, Billy Joel.
Yeah.
An influence on you at all growing up or anything like that? I mean, people are going to make that comparison to Billy, because there aren't that many lead people who do use the keyboard as the lead instrument as well as, be the singer in the group.
Yeah, as for piano players, it's like in the 60s when people were like, you're either a Stones or a Beatles fan, right, and you kind of took camps. I think people kind of did the same thing with Elton John and Billy Joel, and I would have fallen into the Elton John camp a little more.
Really?
But I think I have more in common with Billy Joel. But that's just, I mean, we're both American, and we both write our lyrics and our music.
Uh-huh.
And I think Billy Joel's influenced everybody in a way.
Because there's even a couple of moments on the album where I hear almost direct, a direct two or three or four note line of things.
it's that part where we said Piano Man song.
Right. The Piano Man thing, yeah, exactly. Nice. Which song is that in? I forget.
Oh, I was joking. I don't know. It's called Piano Boy.
There's boxing,
but that has a little more to do with Randy Newman, probably.
Wait a minute now.
It keeps you running. We do that.
We have to go through the whole album, because there's one song. Is it Alice Childress, maybe?
I don't know.
What's the introduction to Alice Childress?
Yes.
See, we could play this game all night, and before you know it, we'd be sniffing glue.
Man. We would be.
Somebody say sniffing glue.
Yes, excuse me. Did the bass player say something?
Bye.
Yeah. You know? Okay.
Well, as long as I put people on it.
As long as I brought up Alice Childress, you want to do it?
Yeah.
Because then we're segueing from Summer B. Now Summer B is a person, right? I mean that's a name, as well as the pun or the play there is, you know, where's Summer B? Where's Summer?
Yeah.
The season. But Summer B, now is that the real name?
Mm-hmm. Summer Burks.
Now, and she's your roommate, but his girlfriend? Is that what you said?
Yeah. We shack up and he...
She's your roommate, but the drummer's girlfriend.
Well, Ben's the boss.
Well, how do you feel about that?
I really don't want to get into this.
No. Oh, okay. All right.
No, I don't. Actually, there's this big thing on the internet about it, and it's really pretty silly. Actually.
You guys have a website, or what? You guys have like a digest, like a discussion group or something, right?
A guy in Pontiac, Michigan, started this thing, and we started getting them at gigs. It's really,
wild. So Summer B, that's a real person. Now Alice Childress. That almost sounds like a name from some novel from earlier in the century or something. Who's Alice Childress?
Alice Childress actually wrote novels and plays, but I'll say that I'd never heard of her when I wrote the song with Anna Goodman, who the co-writer of that song, came up with the name. It came from a woman who's in the hospital she was working at. So it's just this lady threw mop water on her, basically.
In the hospital.
Yeah, she was a mental patient in the 6th South Wing of Vanderbilt Hospital in Nashville.
All right.
And Anna was turning the corner, and the woman was waiting for her in like a wheelchair with some mop water, and doused her with mop water.
But you're telling me, Ben Foles, that then you found out later on there is in fact
People Magazine the next year there was a Alice Childress just died, and then we did an NPR show Sunday morning, Sunday something review something. And the woman, the first thing she goes, very impressive literary, extensive knowledge you have there, Mr. Folds. So tell me about Alice Childress. And I was going, I hate to disappoint you, but I'm stupid.
She was a mental patient. She threw water on my friend.
Yeah, right.
Well, see, at least I was on the right track. I knew the name sounded literary.
Yeah, and then there's Alex Chilton, too, which some people think.
He's a great novelist as well, Alex Chilton.
Definitely.
And that's Robert's roommate.
Robert lives with Alex Chilton?
Yeah, but my boyfriend.
I see. Yeah. Having gone through all of the relationships then, I think it's time here on WNEW for the song.
Okay.
Ready?
In the evening after 6 or 7.
That's such a sad song. A lot of band experience for you guys prior to this band? Are you all veterans of a wide variety of groups over the years or what?
Darren played in Weezer.
You played in Weezer?
No.
Actually, I didn't.
No, oh, okay. That's not a lie.
I see.
It was Tweezer, a local band.
Oh, Tweezer. Then you must know Tweezer Man, one of our sponsors here on NEW.
Not yet. I haven't met him yet.
Well, Tweezer Man is legendary.
Actually, I keep finding small curly hairs on my snare drum, and I'm not sure. I know we've been on tour. I know this is the last couple of nights, and then I noticed again tonight. I don't know, Vin, what do you think?
Well, maybe you're shedding. It's the change of seasons, you know?
Maybe you're shedding eyebrows.
That could be it. I don't know.
Or do you have like chest hair and stuff? Maybe
well,
you're
I have
losing
a little,
some.
I have a little bit.
Those little curly hairs, maybe, you know? Could be happening.
Well, maybe that's it.
All right. Well, we will investigate this while we take a commercial break here on NEW. Yeah, that's it. That's what we need. I see. I'm just gonna get lost in it now. Right, let me tell you what's happening at the bottom line over the next couple of days. A little quieter. Yeah, that's good. That's perfect. I love it. That's great. Tomorrow, that is to say, Monday, it's the Blue Note All-Stars with the Winard Harper Quintet. And then on March 29th, Required Listening, a no-risk evening of discovery, featuring this time around Allison Brown, Craven Dogs, Fred Eagle Smith, and from New Orleans, Mem Shannon, hosted by my radio sister, Rita Houston. On March 30th, you can see Buster Poindexter and his Banshees of Blue at the bottom line. April 3rd and 4th is Al Tan with special guests Paul Brady and Seamus Egan. April 5th, Writers in the Round, Bluebird Style, featuring Richard Barone, Heather Eatman, Jules Shear, and Jill Sobule. I'll read that again because it's a real nice bill. Writers in the Round, Bluebird Style, featuring Richard Barone, Heather Eatman, Jules Shear, and Jill Sobule. April 8th, it's the Wallace Rodney Quintet with the Vincent Herring Quintet. April 9th, Rockapella. April 10th, Taj Mahal with special guest Keb Moe. April 11th through the 14th, a theatrical presentation called Disgracefully Yours, starring Richard O'Brien. April 15th, Don Byron with the Screaming Headless Torsos. And on April 17th, it's the Bill Morrissey Band with Lynn Miles. One more here, April 18th, the music of Frank Zappa with Ed Palermo's 16-piece big band. And special guests Mike Kennelly and Beer for Dolphins. All of these events taking place at the bottom line, 15 West 4th Street in the heart of historic Greenwich Village. 212-228-6300, that's the phone number to call, 212-228-6300. Yeah, with Ben Folds 5 here live on the radio on NEW. You guys, I understand, just got back from Japan, where you were eaten up, I'm told, by those folks who love American music. I mean, they are the biggest fans of American music, and I'm told the biggest fans of Ben Folds 5 as well. What was that experience like?
It was crazy.
Yeah?
It really was. There's no way to describe that.
It was unreal. It's like you go over there and you instantly have a fan club. People are instantly at your hotel, and you're doing all that kind of Beatles-looking stuff.
Little girls in that train, we'd be riding away in the train, and they'd be like running behind and waving and stuff.
How cool is that?
That's pretty cool. It was really neat. It was good. It was good to be able to do that in another country, too. And
all of that comes from the record being played on the radio there, I guess?
Yeah. It's on the radio. It is picking up kind of an underground buzz, too, because it actually started in a record store as an import. The whole thing started with this guy who heard it and started importing it, and it started selling that way, and had Christmas trees up with it, hanging on the trees and stuff. And then the radio picked it up after that, after, the leg of the record company, you know, there just went, oh, maybe we should sell it.
But here's a case where the majority of the people who are listening to the record and who are fans of the band probably don't understand the lyrics, right?
I think that they do. I think that they probably are more into understanding the lyrics than they are, I dare say, over here, because they read the translations, and then they memorize them, and they memorize it phonetically, and they're really into what it is and what it means. And those people ask me some very intelligent questions about the words. I thought it was cool.
So they're paying even more attention than...
I think, in a way.
Yeah, they're not really taking the English language for granted like we might skip over a couple lyrical conventions. Uh-huh. And normally you might, you know, seem kind of blasé, but to them it's like a puzzle. They're like figuring the whole thing out, and so it's like super interesting. Yeah.
And we did a song. We did one of our songs in Japanese too, which was kind of fun.
Did you? Which one?
A Song for the Dumped.
You did it in Japanese?
Yeah, it's called Kane o Kaese in Japanese.
You don't remember it, do you?
I could recite a bit of it, but it's like the song kind of drags if you can't understand the words.
All right. That's the song that's used in the soundtrack of
Mr. Wrong.
Mr. Wrong, mm-hmm. Right? A movie that came and went very quickly. Yeah. But your song will live on.
Didn't come and go while we were on tour, I guess.
Jackson Cannery is one of the big songs over in
that's
Japan.
That's their song.
That's
yeah.
their song?
That's the,
you want to do it?
Yeah.
In English, right?
In English.
Okay, Ben Folds 5, live on the radio on NEW. Ben Folds 5, live on the radio here on NEW. Jackson Cannery, which is the lead track from the debut album from this band. There's the song on your album that made me fall in love with the album is the song Philosophy, right? Yeah. And when we met out in Boulder, Colorado, back last fall sometime, I said to you guys that I was incredibly embarrassed because I had a real mean case of misheard lyric because I had no lyric sheet at that point for the song. So I thought the lyric was, I got my philosophy beat on the brat. All right. Now, the actual lyric, which I found out when I saw you actually perform the song live, the lyric came across loud and clear. It's, I got my philosophy feet on the ground.
Yeah.
Right? But I heard it for a month every time I played that song as beat on the brat. I thought, well, how cool is it? Like a really hip Ramones reference in it. And it twists the song around. I got my philosophy beat on the brat. That's like a weird philosophy. It's a weird way to go through life, you know? So as long as I've brought it up, and as long as I've got a gift for you that I won't give to you unless you play the song, Ben.
Oh.
And guys, will you do it? Ben Fils 5?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Sure.
Thank you.
anyways. See, I told you it sounded just like Beat on the Brat. Even then, when you did it, it still sounded like.
I didn't hear it.
No, I guess.
I can't hear that at all.
I guess not. Well, you beat on the piano, man. Gee whiz. I got to tell you that just before it went into Rhapsody in Blue there at the very end, Ben was literally doing his Jerry Lee Lewis moves there. He was using his feet and stuff to play that thing. You're the only guy who I've ever seen body slam a grand piano as well. It's like you took a dive from a good 10 or 12 feet away when I saw you guys out in Boulder, man. That was pretty scary. That was pretty scary.
It's world-class wrestling or world, what's it called? Mid-Atlantic wrestling.
All right, so here's my gift. I have another job. I don't just do radio on Sunday night, you know. I mean, I know it seems like a glamorous,
you're the guy we
you know, job.
Bought the pretzel from.
That's me down on the Lower East Side a couple of days ago. That's me. That's one of the other jobs. And then I also am the editor of a really cool CD magazine called Grooves that I do with Time Life Music, actually. And the most recent volume, volume 10 of Grooves, features that song, Philosophy, Ben Folds 5. Wow. And I know that you guys would never actually get a copy of this. Like somebody at the record company would get a copy, and maybe your manager would get a copy, but I know it would never actually trickle down to Ben Folds 5. So I am here tonight to present to each of you a copy of Grooves Volume 10 with Philosophy, Ben Folds 5.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you.
There you go. Is that cool? John Hyatt's on the album, and Lisa Loeb, and all kinds of cool people.
Boy George.
And Boy George, yeah.
Buckwheat.
Man.
Is he living with one of you guys now? Or is not really, huh?
Well, that's, you know.
He never paid his
rent. It's kind of sad for me.
When we were setting up for Ben Folds 5, I said to these guys basically that I wouldn't mind if they just played the whole entire album, which we're coming close to doing. Can I make a request right now?
Yes, please.
A song that I just turned my daughter onto the other day. She's 15 years old. We were driving in the car somewhere, and I said, listen to this, and I played Underground. She got this big smile on her face. You know, I think she's the exact right age for Underground. 15-year-old. When the song was done, I said, so what do you think? And she goes, cool. So what do you say? Ben Folds 5, Underground.
Cool.
I was never cool in school. I'm sure you don't remember me. And now it's been 10 years. I'm still wondering who to be. But I'd love to mix in circles, clicks, and social coteries. That's me. Hand me my nose ring. Can we be happy? Show me the mosh pit. Can we be happy? We can be happy underground.
think you guys touch base with just about every form of American music from the last 50 years in that song, man. That is so cool. I love that nice jazz influence there at the end. Are you studied in that at all? Have you played straightforward jazz piano at any point along the way, Ben?
I did a couple little lounge one-off things here and there where I tried. I'm not much of a jazz player.
Did you go to school? I mean, did you like do university and stuff with music in
a little bit? A little bit. I was studying drums at University of Miami.
Really?
For a whole semester. Uh-huh. And then I went back to North Carolina State School for a while.
Did you ever actually go to class and stuff in Miami? Because nobody I know goes to school in Miami ever goes to class.
Actually, I went to all of them, and my last class, I realized that I wasn't getting the grade point average that I needed to sustain my little scholarship, and I threw my drums in the lake.
Oh.
So I missed the last day. Okay. I threw my drums in the lake. It's done.
So you went back to North Carolina?
Yep.
And studied English? Huh?
Yep.
Like literature?
Yeah, English lit.
Yeah. Cool.
For like two semesters, I was out of there.
I like where the jazz influence comes into the songs from time to time. I mean, the songs they may hit you over the head with volume and humor and stuff, but musically the songs are real subtle and real intricate. I mean, there's some interesting arrangements going on here. Is that something you guys all work on together? Arrangements?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. I bring the stuff in and go, hey, let's try this.
Cool. Uncle Walter?
Yes.
Tell me about this guy. Like everybody else who appears in your songs actually with a given name is a real person.
Yeah.
How about Uncle Walter? Is he a real person?
Uncle Walter is a real uncle of a friend of mine, but really the character that it was inspired from was a woman who was the mother of a fellow bandmate in a garage band when I was 14. And they'd leave. I was 14, they were 16. They'd leave the house. And she was just this kind of old, sad, and alcoholic lady who might have been okay other than she was just, like, just depressed. And she would she'd try me in the corner and just tell me about all the things she'd do if she was president and just talk my ear off. And it was scary.
Yeah.
And so, I remembered a lot of the things that she had said. In fact, I'd written a lot of them down at the time. And so, 10 years later, I wrote the song.
Was she always under the influence, or did the delusions begin to take hold without the alcohol?
I wouldn't know. I didn't know enough about any of that then. It was just a white bread upbringing. That was the first thing I'd ever seen that was scary like that. But she eventually actually died she was taking like one of those showers where you just stick your head under the faucet, You're looking at somebody. Am I?
No, okay. Okay.
And she hit her head on the faucet and passed out in the water and drowned in the water. So. That's it for her.
See, I was actually looking at David, our engineer, because this very same thing happened to him last week. I don't know if you're aware of this. And he did, in fact, drown in the water, and he's passed on, and we keep him here. It's okay. He does the shows.
I'm sorry I was laughing at him earlier.
No, David? No, it's okay. You can laugh at him as much as you want.
Now I know why.
Yeah,
I
that's
understand.
Why. That's why. It's because he's deceased.
Yeah.
He's in fact a corpse. Yeah. Oh, now he's upset. Now
I'm not dead.
You could have fooled me, man.
Anybody with a rebel sign on his T-shirt that says "I whoop ass."
There you go.
You should definitely stay away from him.
So, Uncle Walter. Now this woman gets transposed into this other character in this song.
And so I just took a typical reigning old stupid, old guy who's sitting in front of the TV set, because really I started realizing that there's a lot of guys that are like 55 years old who don't have any more experience than I did when I was 20.
Uh-huh.
They hadn't been around. They've been sitting in their armchair watching TV the whole time, and they give you advice and tell you things like they know what it is, but they don't really know anything. They were sitting in front of the TV set. So so that's where the song kind of came from.
And you know what happened? At a certain point along the way, they were handed a remote control so that they don't even have to get up out of the chair, man.
That's the video, by the way.
Is it really?
The video is going to be our producer, who's a freak, in an armchair that's mechanical, and we're going to have him flying down the street riding with the cars and stuff.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Cool. So. With his
remote control and his beer and his cigarettes. Okay.
And now, is he attempting to, like, change the people in the cars and stuff like that? Or does he realize that he's out in the real world now?
Well, we'll be filming it next week, so I think we'll work that part out. I think he's going to be delusional, though. I think he's going to see things in a different way, and then you'll see what he's really seeing, and he'll be making speeches to pigeons and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, here's the song, then. Okay. Live on the radio, Ben Folds 5, Uncle Walter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when I listen to your record, man, you guys make me smile all the time. Seeing you do it live just makes me laugh. Man. It just takes that smile and brings it to a whole other place. That is so much fun. With that electric bass lead there happening towards the end of the song. Ben Folds 5, Uncle Walter. So that's I guess, what, the new single or the next emphasis track or something like that from
yes,
the album?
Okay. It is.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And the video to be filmed, where are you going to do it?
Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
Back home. Okay,
yeah,
cool. If I were to travel on the tour bus with Ben Folds 5, what music would I be hearing? What do you guys listen to when you're on the bus?
I think Built to Spill was something that we listened to a lot for a while.
What is that? Tell me about Built to Spill.
Built to Spill is a band from Boise, Idaho. I think it's basically one guy, but I'm not sure.
Doug Marsh
is, I think, his name. And he writes such great songs. He's really a great songwriter. I really like the Radiohead record a lot.
Okay.
I think that's great. And the Archers of Loaf just put out a kind of a compilation of B-sides and rare tracks. It's an amazing record.
Yeah.
It really is good.
How about, is there any older stuff that you guys will travel with on the road just to kind of get away from modern music? You know, I was thinking, listening to Uncle Walter, that Uncle Walter really is a sort of a very direct relative connection to Uncle Ernie from right? I mean, I wouldn't want to get Uncle Ernie and Uncle Walter in the same room together, right? From the Who's Tommy. Is there any older stuff you guys would listen to on the bus as well?
I like Joni Mitchell, Blue.
Really?
That's my favorite record. Of course, I don't really know the others a whole lot, but I think Blue is amazing because we don't need no reason, people.
Yeah. So for a little more of a quiet, mellow mood on the van.
Yeah, start crying, think about my girlfriend.
Oh, man. Your girlfriend is the one that lives with him, right? With Ben. Is that right?
Absolutely not, actually.
No. Oh, no, it's the drummer's girlfriend who lives with Ben.
A little touchy about that, are you, Robert?
Huh?
A little touchy about that, huh?
Hey, look, we'll be off tour soon enough.
All right. We'll see.
Darren, how about you? Favorite record on the tour bus?
Well, I'd have to say right now it's the Flaming Lips, Clouds Taste Metallic. It's their new record, which will be a classic,
right.
I guarantee it.
Okay, now who's driving this bus? I hope none of you guys are driving this bus, because so far you're doing some pretty raucous music here, you know? It's like,
we take turns. We all drive.
Yeah,
It's basically just a rider truck that has a big wall in the back and a couple of bunks.
Yeah. Okay. Ben Folds 5 fans out there in Radio Land would be very upset with me if I didn't say to you guys, you want to do some new songs? Want to do some songs that aren't on the record?
Yes.
Oh, cool. Then they won't be upset with me.
No, they won't.
Okay. What are you going to do? Tell us about these songs.
Well, this first song is a song about a guy who's very small and gets beat up in school when he's younger, and later on goes on to be very successful. And later on, then he.
I'm raising my hand here. So far, this sounds very familiar. Yes?
So then I guess he hires someone to round these people up and puts them in his basement, and he makes a little speech to them. It's called One Angry Dwarf and 200 Solemn Faces.
I'm
subtitled Revenge of the Dwarf, I guess, huh? One Angry Dwarf and 200 Solemn Faces. Now, is it, since that's the first time we've heard the song, is it made clear in the song what he's become successful at later on in life?
No.
No, okay. It's just that he's, the whole idea is now, he's brought the tormentors back in the basement, man. What, yeah. That's cool. That is so cool. There is nobody listening to the radio right now who can't relate to that song. There is nobody who doesn't have maybe not 200 tormentors, but 3 or 4, you know, who they'd like to get in the basement at some point along the way and say, you shouldn't have done that back when we were all 8 years old. Cool. Well, that's a new song from Ben Folds 5. How about another one?
Okay, yeah, this is called Stephen's Last Night in the Town. We've done this a few times live. We usually use a melodica, and I stand up. But we're going to try it a different way now, and this is scary because it's going on live, but we're stunt musicians, so we're going to do it. This is a song about a guy named Stephen, and he comes over to visit, which is true. He came over to visit, and, like, he wouldn't leave. Every night, he's still there visiting. So we throw a party for him. We say, Stephen, it's your last night in town. Let's have a party for you. You go, great. And the next night, he's like, let's throw another party. It's my last night in town. So every single night. So it's called Stephen's Last Night in Town, which is every night. Every night now is Stephen's last night. He wouldn't leave. Bastard. One, two, one, two, one.
Last night in town.
Falls 5 live on the radio. Steven's last night in town. You guys are dealing with some real sort of primal archetypes here, you know? The revenge of the nerd, the guy who gets back, gets back at all those people who tortured him when he was young. The house guest who refuses to leave, right? The house guest from hell.
Yeah.
Did you finally get rid of him, Steven, or is he still there?
Yeah, he's gone now.
Oh, okay. All right, he is out. There was finally a last night then for Steven.
Yeah.
He did finally get out. All right, cool.
I think we should do one about the guy that goes into the bathroom and uses all the toilet paper.
There you go. See, this is refreshing material for songs. You know, too many songs are full of this kind of morose introspection. And, you know, my boyfriend left me, my girlfriend screwed me, blah, blah, blah.
My boyfriend left me, yeah, my girlfriend screwed me. Yeah, she screwed me.
See, what I like about Ben Folds 5 is you guys don't do songs like that. You know, it's a whole different thing.
Because I wouldn't know what key it was in.
Yeah. Right. Now, listen, you just did a couple of new songs. Let me ask you another question. It's one of the things that I like doing with musicians and bands and stuff is asking people if they cover other people's songs. Do you do anybody else's songs?
We do some other songs.
From time to time?
From time to time. We kind of jump from Jimi Hendrix to Built to Spill to... just stupid 80s songs.
Yeah. Jimi Hendrix?
Yeah.
What Jimi Hendrix do you do?
Crosstown Traffic.
Really?
Yeah.
Can you give me a little bit of it?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah? Cool. That's Robert doing the lead vocal on that, channeling the ghost and spirit of Jimi Hendrix there, man.
Yeah,
cool.
I mean, I felt it.
Cool.
Must have been the bandana with all the acid.
Well, there, and also being here in New York, where, man, he did a lot of cool stuff here in New York. You
yeah,
know?
He did. So, actually, I saw that documentary about when his girlfriend talks about they were living in New York.
Yeah. And, yeah. Jimmy's still dead, though, man. He's still out there floating around.
He's coming back.
Yeah. What stupid 80s song do you do?
This one.
Lying awake until they're tuning in on you. If I were young and didn't stop you coming.
guys are sick, twisted, demented, bad boys. Video did not kill a radio star, because I was here before video and I'm still around. So, and I'm still doing it, and I'm still successful.
Good for you, baby.
The Buggles, man, where are they now? Where are the Buggles now? Oh, they're in Brazil. I see. Ben Folds 5. About to go to Europe, I understand.
Yeah.
Doing England and Germany and stuff.
That's
like
right.
That. Is that first time over for you guys or what?
It's a band, yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Cool. So that should be exciting.
Yeah.
And there's nothing coming up like here in the city or this area, right? In terms of concerts and stuff at this point. Is there something we want to plug?
No, I don't think so. I don't believe so. I haven't heard about anything yet.
Producer Manning has handed me a note that Trevor Horn from the Buggles is a producer these days. He's a top producer. Is that true? Top producer? Who does he produce? A lot of people. Okay, thank you. Who? Seal? Trevor Horn produces Seal? Wow, cool. Yeah. How about my staff, huh? Crack staff? You ask a question, they got the answer, right?
They're on it.
Where did these come from?
Glue bottles. Yeah, there you go. So I'm glad we finally got a chance to do radio together.
Yeah.
I've been wanting to do this for a long time, and the timing finally worked out, so that's cool.
Yeah.
So where's management? Are there any dates coming up in New York we should know about, management? Hello? Come here, Alan. Anything happening that we should know about soon? No. Okay.
I said to him, there's no gigs.
I said to him.
Watch out for the manager, guys. All right, so I think that there's definitely the makings of a bootleg album here tonight.
Yeah.
In the Ben Folds 5 live on the radio. Anybody out there who's been running that DAT tape, they can go ahead and do it. That's what bootlegs are all about, right? Don't you think?
Wait a minute, hold it.
Ben's our new manager.
All right, listen, I'm going to kick you guys out of here after one more song. I can't let you go without hearing Julianne.
Okay.
All right?
We'll do that, but okay. We'd like to thank you a lot for having us on the show.
Hey,
it's really
been,
cool.
It's been great fun for me, man. Thank you.
Well, let's rock the kids then, shall we?
Yeah.
Oh, that's disgusting.
This girl, she looked like Axl Rose. Got drunk and took her home, and we slept in her clothes. And in the morning, put my feet on the floor and thought, being awake never felt like this before. And Julianne, I knew she wouldn't prove. Talked all day on the phone, cause I had nothing to do. Got rid of Axl by the afternoon. Being awake never felt so clear.
Robert Sledge on bass, Darren Jesse on drums, Ben Foles on piano and lead vocal, Ben Foles 5. Get this piano, get those drums, get all those amplifiers out of here. You guys are off the radio. Thanks for a cool performance tonight, man. This was great. Ben Foles 5 here on NEW 102.7.